Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to this performance of Hairspray. Hairspray takes place in Baltimore in 1962, a time before there were mobile phones. And we hope that we can travel back to that time where there would be none heard during a performance. We would also like to remind you that the use of recording equipment and taking of photographs is strictly prohibited. Thank you for your cooperation and enjoy the show!
That'll be $3.
That's pretty pricey for a few pairs of penny pants.
Well, I'm sorry, Prudy Pingleton, but there are a few extra jobs. Some of your personal states require pounding on the rug.
I'm home.
Ah, 4 o'clock. Yes, I didn't mean to ask you got detention again. Tracy Turnblad, mind your manners. Say hello to our guest.
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton.
You too, Penny.
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton. I mean, Mother.
Teenagers, they just love watching that corny talent.
Delinquents. And ain't right dancing to that colored music.
Don't be silly, it ain't colored. The TV's black and white.
Maybe we should make it official.
Rick! New council member, Rick! Oh, how sweet! And it matches my hair color exactly!
None of that! Save your personal lives for the camera. Add her back in 5, 4, 3.
Louis crowning, your choice, the Miss Teenage Hairspray, 1962.
My big break!
Oh, isn't she a lovely slim girl?
Oh, well, I guess Amber's pretty, but she can't dance. Plastic, little spastic. Oh, no! I'm gonna kill myself! Look! She's wearing Link Larkin's tonsil ring! Okay, gang! Don't forget to watch Mom and Me next Thursday on Mother Dog!
Expected, Amber. And speaking of expecting the unexpected, a very own phone. little Lee the Baptist from the show. How long have you got for, Brenda? So it seems we'll have an opening for gals just as fun loving, but maybe not quite as free, will we? Want to be one of the nicest kids in town? Head to school tomorrow, call down to station WTTT to audition.
Oh my god, it's the dream of a lifetime. I have to go audition. Oh my god, it's the dream of a lifetime. I have to go audition.
That will be enough of that for one day. No one's auditioning for anything. There'll be no cutting school in this house.
But this is terrible.
Penny, go tell your mother. She wants you.
She does? I better hurry. Bye, Mrs. Turnblad. Bye, Tracy. Bye.
Whoa, rush hour traffic. Beep, beep. Oink, oink. Hiya, ladies.
Wilbur.
Since I got that new shipment of exploding bubblegum, business downstairs is booming. How am I too funny, honeys? And how are these two fun honeys?
Stop it, Wilbur. You're the funny one.
Daddy, tomorrow I'm auditioning to dance in a TV show.
You are going to have to go further than that to get around me, young lady. No one's auditioning for anything. And what did I tell you about that hair? All ratted up like a teenage Jezebel.
Mother, you are so 50s. Even our first lady, Jackie, the Kennedy, rats her hair.
Yeah? Well, you ain't no first lady, are you? She's a hair hopper, that's what she is. And they got her put into detention. Again. Wilbur, talk to her. Girls like Tracy, people like us, you know what I'm saying? They don't put people like us on television except to be laughed at.
Tracy, this TV thing... You really want it?
Oh, it's my dream, Daddy.
Then you go for it! This is America, babe. You gotta think big to be big.
Being big is not the problem, Wilbur.
When I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with a circus. But I said, no, that's what you want. I had dreams of my own. I dreamt of opening a chain of joke shops worldwide. So... okay, I've still only got one, but someday if I can figure out how to keep the air from leaking out of my sofa-sized whoopee cushion, I'm going to make a noise heard round the world. You follow your dream, baby. I'm grabbing an orange crush and heading back down to the Hardy Har Hut. I got my dream, and I love it.
You are not helping, Wilbur.
Thanks, Daddy.
Tracy Tallulah Turnblad. Get back up here. I have hampers of laundry and my diet pill is wearing off.
But, Mama, I want to be famous.
Mama, I want to be famous.
Learn how to get blood out of car upholstery. Now, that is a skill you can take right to the bank. You think I wanted to spend my life washing and ironing other people's clothes? No. I wanted to design them. I thought that I would be the biggest thing in brassieres. Well... be careful what you wish for. Now, start folding.
But all I was doing was watching Corny Collins over on Tracy.
Did I forbid you from listening to race music? Oh, if the police ever locate your father, he'll punish you good.
Your dancing was atrocious today, Amber. I'm willing to lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crown, but you've got to work with me. Now let me have that zit.
Stop! That's no way to treat clean clothes. One day you will own Edna's Occidental Laundry. Will you be ready?
I hope not! Don't contradict me!
Don't disobey me!
Don't even think about going to that audition!
Please!
No!
Mother!
Stop telling me what to do!
Don't
treat me like a child of two!
No!
I know that you want what's best!
Please!
But Mother, please!
Stop, don't go, please. Stop, don't go, please. Stop, don't go.
found Miss Baltimore Krabs.
Oh, phew! I thought we'd never get here! Stupid bus crash! All my life I imagined what this place would look like! Oh, this is an idiot. Hi there! Am I too late to audition?
Not too late, dear. Just too much.
I see. Look, oh, it's Link. Oh, Link Larkin. So near and yet so gorgeous.
I know. Those girls were all over me. I don't know how Rock Hudson stands it. Excuse me, little darling. I hope I didn't end your due.
I can hear the bells. Tracy, are you all right? Well, don't you hear them chime?
I don't hear anything.
Can't you feel my heartbeat keeping perfect time? And oh, me. He looked at me and stared, yes, he bumped me. My heart was unprepared when he tapped me and knocked me off my feet. One little touch.
loud.
Oh, now.
Oh. I kept school to come down here. Isn't that too cool?
Detention's a rainbow experience. Woo. to attract the girl. Opposite sex.
Oh.
Fearless girl, you really got it going.
Oh, this program's joining you already in progress.
Oh, my God. I just realized who you are. You dance a Negro Day.
Of course he does. His mom hosts the show.
Your mom is Mona Mouth Bay Bell, the DJ?
Yep.
Well, that makes you like royalty. Negro Day is the best. I wish every day were Negro Day.
Oh. You see, at our house, it is. So you're gonna get on if you're the black news. Oh. So, how you feeling about the tension now?
Oh, I'm a bad, bad girl! Who needs to be punished? I'm bad, I'm bad.
Smiling, laughing, dancing in detention. Tracy Turnblad, you can give up all hopes of college. I'm putting you into special ed with the rest of these characters.
College! Where do you go after special ed?
Congress!
Somewhere. Oh my God! Blake Mormon just called to me! I'll never wash his hair again!
Now when I see
everywhere.
Oh, my word, Tracy live in our own living room.
I think I've seen her here before.
And she's going to be a regular.
Imagine my little girl regular at last.
Hi, Tracy. It's me. It's Penny.
Honey, she can't hear you. Hello? Yes, this is her childhood home. No, I'm not her father.
So let's wave a wistful bye-bye to Brenda. See you next year! And inaugurate the newest member of our council, Tracy Term, that cozy up to old Corny. And tell us about yourself, Tracy.
Well, I go to Patterson Park High, I watch your show, and I do absolutely nothing else!
What would your first official act be?
I would make every day Negro Day!
I read you like tomorrow's headlines, Trace. What do you say, kids? Looks like we might have a hot new candidate from his teenage hairspray.
No!
She can't be Miss Hairspray. She's the before in the Metrical Diet ad, and I am the after. Actors always win.
Amber, what a comedian! So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Nick Larkin to sing a song just for you?
No! I can't! Because everybody knows that when he sings to me. He is completely involved in me. See?
Right. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Nick Larkin to sing a song just for you? Tracy Turnblad. This version of this week's top 40 hit, It Takes Two.
And so I will wait until that moment.
kissing on the mouth, with possibly parted lips. I assure you, controversy is not what Ultra Clubs wishes to promote.
Negroes and chubby girls buy hairspray too, Mr. Spritzer.
Mrs. Von Tussle, how do you plan to handle this?
I plan to start by firing him.
You can't fire Corny Collins from the Corny Collins Show.
Why not? They do it all the time on Lassie.
Mr. Spritzer, to keep your audience, you've got to keep up with the times.
The show's fine the way it is.
Bringing Tracy on is just the beginning. I've got terrific ideas for updating the show.
I'm getting one of my sick headaches. Is there a place I might lie down?
There's a bed in my office. So, you've got ideas, do you? And going behind my back with this no-talent commie on the show is one of them?
Damn right, Velma. It's time we put kids on the show who look like the kids who watch the show.
Not while I'm producing it.
Well, I was thinking it might be time to change that, too.
Are you threatening me, Collins?
You know me, Velma. On the other hand, I could always take the show to Channel 11.
Oh my God, that snake, that sings, he's a puppet. But I hold the purse and the strings. God, I knew Negro Dave would bring chaos and change. Now he's pushing us people like kids on mate. Blackhead that must be good smell. There's a standard of beauty that must be upheld.
Tracy appreciates your vote for Miss Teenage Hairspray, yeah. And she loves you too. Very much. Whoever you are. Goodbye. Oh, this is crazy. Hello? What am I wearing? A house dress, scuffies, sport hose. What are you wearing? Oh. Hello.
Mama, did you see me? Did you see me?
Of course I did. It was on television. I had to. The phone has been ringing like we was a telethon. To think a beloved TV icon, the fruit of my womb.
So you're not mad?
Mad? How can I be mad? You're famous. If only you told me you was going to get on the show, I never would have said you couldn't. That's it. Tell me. Fame everything you thought it would be. Are you happy, honey?
Oh, yes, Mama. And I think I'm in love!
I've been following! But you and I are going to have a talk about crooners. We can learn a lot from the mistakes of Miss Debbie Reynolds. There it goes again!
Hello? Oh, yes, this is Tracy Turnblad. Hello, Mr. Pinky?
Mr. Pinky, what theme Mr. Pinky has in...
Mr. Pinky's Hefty Hideaway. Quality clothes for quantity gals.
That Mr. Pinky.
You want to hire me as your exclusive spokesgirl in fashion effigy? Ah! 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 Well, what's an effigy?
No clue. Oh.
Well, that's very flattering, but I'm afraid all business must go through my agent. It would be our pleasure. We'll be right over, Mr. Pinky. Goodbye.
An agent. I don't know any agents. How about a nice parole officer?
Mother, put that thing down. I'm taking my new agent to the Hefty Hideaway and then out of the town.
Oh, me? Tracy Turnblad, fame has gone to your head and left you wacky. You mean a top-shelf professional. Who handled the Gabor sisters? Well, who didn't?
Mother, there's a great big world out there I know nothing about. When things get rough, a girl needs her mother.
Oh, honey, if that's what you want... I'll be right beside you once you get a little lawyer waking us up. Ollie, can we do it over the phone? I haven't been out of this apartment since Mamie Eisenhower rolled her hose and bought her bangs.
Well, you certainly have picked a lovely girl to put the plus into your plus sizes.
Now, Tracy, this can't be your agent. She must be your gorgeous big sister.
Mr. Pinky, you're twisting my head. I'm not the gorgeous big sister. I'm
54 double G.
Triple E.
Oh, Mama, I hit the mother load. Step inside.
went to song.
Hey, everybody, look, here they come. Special ad. Snicker, snicker, sneer, sneer.
Hey, that ain't cool, Fender. Knock it off. Try to act like a grown up.
Special ad went to bed.
Oh, yeah, come on.
Hey, you got a prayer for me too. This game can get pretty vicious.
Well, what is scatter dodgeball anyway?
It's sort of like a protest rally, you know? When the police show up, you better scatter and dodge.
Hi, Tracy. Oh, sorry about your special ads. This, but just think of it as a testament to the record-breaking extremes your hair has reached. I'm so jealous. Hello! Seaweed, this is my best friend, Penny Lou Pingleton.
Oh. Hey. Oh, wait, I've seen you before. Yeah, at the gum machine. Getting your Wrigley's.
Yeah, I do 2 packs a day.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that chewing must make the muscles in your mouth mighty strong.
No, not really, Emmy. They're probably just average. Yeah! Well, Tracy Tugboat! You finally found a title you could win. Miss Special Ed.
Hey, knock it off, Amber!
It's beginning of a home.
from?
Mrs. Mona Mandel.
Hey, Mona. I brought some friends.
Ooh, whoop-de-doo. What a coup. The ever-sparking Sir Link. Larkin.
Always nice to see you, Miss Watermelon.
I'm Penny Lou Pingleton, and I'm very pleased and scared to be here.
You're welcome, kitten, to come and sit in.
This is just so astro-tastic! Can I say how thrilled I am to meet you? I'm Seaweed's friend, Tracy.
Oh, yes, indeedy. I've seen you, sweetie. All aglow on Corny's show.
Oh, gee, thanks. Well, the only reason I'm on that show is because of your son. Why can't we all dance together like this on TV?
Think we haven't tried? We've pleaded, begged, and lied. We've pressured the man, petitioned the gods. What did we get?
One day a month.
Oh, you're not a toy, you came to dance. Let's bring some hot chic up in here.
We're not dancing on Negro Day. You're crashing White Day!
What day is every day? You gotta get more specific than that.
Well, is tomorrow specific enough? Think, it's mother-daughter day. Miss Watermouth, you work for the station. They can never turn you and little Inez away. And once the two of you break the barrier, we'll all be free to dance together on TV!
Oh, that thing is downright revolutionary!
Come on! Those sparks like Rosa Parks!
Child, it ain't that easy. This ain't bar cheesy. What if they call the cops? Somebody could get hurt.
Well, then we'll all walk out together. There's me, there's Link, and I'm sure we can get the others. Without dancers, they've got no show.
She's got that, right?
Yeah. What a decision. Your girl's got vision.
We've always thought of do what's right and give correct change.
Tracy, you can't do this. You're new to the council. You'll be blackballed in front of the show for sure.
Well, that's why we're all going to do it together.
Not me.
You don't think segregation is wrong?
I like these people. But whether or not they're on TV won't get me a recording contract. No, that came out wrong. Look, I've been singing and dancing and smiling on that show for 3 years, waiting for it to lead to my break. You. So you got everything. Brains, talent, personality. Me, I've got one chance to be seen nationwide. Oh, Tracy. This Saturday night is everything I've worked for, and I'm not going to throw it away. So, come on. I'm leaving, and you've got to go, too. Come on.
No! I want to do this! And so should you. It's what's right. Link, stay. Please.
I'm sorry.
But you and me together? Well, I was just starting to think of
you. Sure. Me too, but... I don't know. Look, it's getting too complicated. And there's still... Emma. See ya, little darling.
Oh, I'm sorry, Tracy.
Beautiful girl. It's just that Eddie Fisher all over again.
Oh, Mama, don't tease. I really liked him. I've never felt anything like this before.
I know, and he probably likes you too. It's just boys are not the brightest things.
Still, give him time. I'm sure he'll figure out he's crazy about you.
Well, you have to say that. You're my mother.
I'm more than your mother. I'm a woman in love. We know about this stuff.
But Tracy, he could be right. Should you risk your career?
I never would have gone on that show without Seaweed. No! It's payback time!
That's my girl!
Okay, so this is how we're gonna do it. Tomorrow, everyone bring your mothers.
And sisters!
And meet around the corner from the studio and make signs!
Yes!
Inez will walk out first, and me and Mama will be right behind you.
Excuse me.
Well, they'll never be able to shove them back out the door with us for locking it.
Sorry. I'm sorry, Tracy, but nobody said anything to me about appearing on television. I'm sorry, but I simply cannot appear on television at my present weight.
You can't let weight restrict your fate! Look at me! Ha ha! I'm on TV!
Ah, but Miss Motormouth, you are a celebrity, whereas I am a simple housewife of indeterminate girth.
The bigger the girth, the more you're worth! Amen. Mr. Turnblad, you don't mind that the missus here is an ample American, do you?
Not at all. I think of her as prime real estate.
Yeah, nice and roomy. You listen to me. Once upon a time, girl, I was just like you. Never let my extra large march.
gentlemen, and kids. Let me take this opportunity to remind you that it's still 1962, so turn off those mobile phones. Also remember, the use of cameras and recording devices is still prohibited. So with no further ado-do, that's Doo-Doo Act 2. Thank you.
To think that I would live to have a rap sheet. If my mother were alive, she would be so proud. Remember, your grandma was a suffragette.
Right! You haven't heard the last from us, Mrs. Von Tussle. We'll be marching again, and soon to the beat of a whole new era.
Bang your drum, Bonzo. No one cares. Don't get any more cute ideas about protesting or even showing off the special. I'll have armed guards surrounding the Eventorium to make sure Tracy can't get within 100 miles of that place. Game, set, match.
Ladies, you're free to go with sincere apologies, State Merlin. And the personal compliments of the governor himself.
The governor! Really? Sweet, chubby Millard. We dated on and off in college. It pays to have a politician in your pocket and the Polaroids in your safe. Now, if you two double-wide twins will excuse me, I have a national television spectacular to produce.
I was never here. This never happened. Oh, Tracy! Any message for Link? Place it on my lips. I'll be sure he gets it.
Bang! Bye! So long, Baltimoreans!
I still do not care for them.
I hear you, Miss T. Although, this little old jail just got a whole lot nicer.
Mm-hmm.
You got a visitor! Bell has been posted!
Thank the Lord for those who can afford.
I posted bail!
Wilbur! But how?
Simple, really. I mortgaged the Hardy Hot.
Oh, Daddy!
Wilbur, that place is your life.
You too are my life. Bail for everyone! Bail for the house! You're free to go!
The Turnblad gang are real good folks. They have the heart. They get the jokes.
All prisoners, kindly turn in your tap shoes on the way out.
Shall we make haste?
Hold up, Candyman. We're keeping that Rotown travel rouser on ice.
I paid for everyone. Got a group discount.
Turnblad is here. Without bail. She has to be moved to solitary confinement. Held until further notice by special order of the governor's office. So there you are.
The governor's office? Mm-hmm. Mrs. Von Tussle! Manipulating our judicial system to win a contest is un-American.
Don't make things worse for yourself. Move out peacefully.
I'm not leaving here without my daughter.
Oh, it's okay, Daddy. They can't keep me here forever. Besides, I've got a lot to think about. I might as well do it in solitary refinement.
I'm counting to three, and then I'm going to re-arrest y'all for legal trespass.
Oh, let's go. We can't do Tracy any good here.
Hey!
Touch one hair on my little girl's head, and I will be back to teach you a whole new meaning for split ends.
Keep the faith, baby.
They haven't heard the last from us, honey.
You're so lucky. You get out of the algebra final.
I'm all alone. My heart has grown, but it's broken too. This morning life was a Baltimore fairy tale. Now I can't make bail.
yes, Mr. Pinky. Of course, I understand that you have an empire to protect her, but I... Yes, I'll return the outfits. The petty pants, too, I scarcely wore them. But Mr. Pinky, she is just a little girl. And little girls make mistakes. If they didn't, where would other little girls come from? Well, that is too bad. Goodbye, Mr. Pinky. Oh, Wilbur, this is a real my doll moment.
I'm closing up.
Wilbur, my stomach's in knots. My nerves are on edge.
Calm down, sweetheart.
I can't calm down. There are names for women who've abandoned their daughters who have gotten themselves arrested for trying to integrate an after-school sock hop-type television show. Yes, there are names. And Hallmark does not make a card for any of them.
You can't worry about people calling you names. You know how many times I've been called crazy? But I say, yeah, crazy. Crazy like a loon. Anyway, we haven't abandoned her. In fact, I got what Tracy needs just here. Stand back. What do you think? Isn't it a doozy?
Impressive. But how's a little thing like that going to help our Tracy?
You'll be surprised.
Oh, sure. You're a big inventor saving the day, and Tracy's a teen idol reshaping the world. But what am I? I had dreams too, you know. Used to make all my own clothes, remember? Until I wandered beyond the boundaries of the largest McCall's dress pattern. I always dreamed that one day I would put out my own line of queen-size dress patterns.
You were good, Edna.
Yeah? Where's it got me? 20 years later and I'm still washing and mending and ironing everybody else's clothing.
One day, Edna.
No day, Wilbur. My time has come and gone. I'm like a half-filled book of green stems. Beyond redemption. Wilbur, I suddenly feel so old.
Nonsense, Doc. You're as spry as a slinky. Whenever I'm near you, it's like grabbing hold of a giant joy muscle. Styles keep a-changing. The world's rearranging. But Edna, your time is to me. Hemlines of sugar. A beer plus a quarter. Just getting ripe away late. You're like a fatal disease, babe.
Well,
but there's no cure, so let this fever rage. Some folks can't stand it. Say time is a bandit, but I take the opposite view. Cause when I need a lift, time brings a gift for the day with you. A twist or a waltz. You're timeless to me.
Oh, Wilbur. Facts keep fading. Gastro's invading. But Wilbur, you're timeless to me. Hairdos are higher. Mine feels like barbed wire. But you say I'm chic as can be. You're like a rare vintage ripple. A vintage they'll never forget. So pour toast the fact we ain't dead yet. I can't stop eating. Your hairline's receding. Soon there'll be nothing at all. So you wear a wig while I roast a pig. Hey! Pass the Jared's all. Glenn Miller had brass. Chubby check is a guess. But they all pass even jewelry. You'll never be passé.
shot. Your time's to me.
You're only free to show mon amour. Your time's to me.
French. Nice. I can feel the bells. You'll always be first string.
Ring a ding ding.
Bien. Et répétez.
Ring a ding ding.
Merci beaucoup. Your time is to
timeless.
To me.
It's Tracy. Where are you? It's me.
Link Larkin?
From the show?
Link, over here!
Shh, the guard's asleep. Gee, you look beautiful behind bars.
Oh, it must be the low watt institutional lighting. Link, what are you doing here?
Aw, Tracy, seeing you being dragged off to jail brought me back to my senses. I thought I'd lose it when I thought I'd lost you. I couldn't eat, I couldn't sing, I couldn't even concentrate.
You couldn't eat?
No. So I went down to the station to tell Mrs. Von Tussel that I was through the Miss Hairspray broadcast.
You did?
I didn't. When I got to the station, I overheard Mrs. Von Tussel talking to Spritzer. And, Tracy, it's Amber. The talent scouts are coming to see. It had nothing to do with me. All this time, I thought Amber and I were a team. But she and her mother were just using me to make her look popular. I feel like such an idiot.
Well, that makes two of us.
I know a palooka like me isn't worthy of a groundbreaking extremist like you, but it's a little scuffed after Amber threw to my face when I told I'd rather be with you.
You did?
I did, so would you consider wearing my ring?
Would I?
To lose thee were to lose myself. Some kid named Milton wrote that on the third floor boys' room.
Oh, it's beautiful. I have a good life, great parents, my own room, stacks of 45s, three sweaters, plus a learner's permit due through August. And do you know what I've been missing? A link?
Oh, I think I do. A selfish fool who never understood. I never looked inside myself, though on the outside I look good. Then we met and you made me the man I am today. Tracy, I'm in love with you, no matter what you wear. My love, life is like the seasons with no summer.
Yeah.
rabble-rouser Tracy Turkland has escaped from the Baltimore Women's House of Detention. Authorities believe she may have been aided by the once promising, formerly wholesome teen idol, Link Clark. If sighted, citizens are asked to notify police, or if phone service is not available, simply shoot to kill. In entertainment news, Eva Marie is no saint.
Lord have pity! It's a crazy city! Who's at the back door? One. Oh, my baby. And Penny, is it?
Yes, ma'am. Pee-wee's got a girlfriend.
Hey, it's okay. I brought her home. I had to get her away from her nasty-ass mama.
Hush now. Don't explain. I've got an inkling and a twinkling. First time I seen you two dancing together.
And you don't mind?
I never mind love. It's a gift from above. But not everybody remembers that. So you two better brace yourselves for a whole lot of ugly coming at you from a never-ending parade of stupid.
Oh, that's okay. My mother's gonna kill me anyway.
No, she won't. She'll kill him.
Come on, Tracy. Hey, Miss Motormouth, we broke Tracy out of jail.
Yeah, we know. It's been on all three channels.
Well, the jail break was easy compared to getting a cab to this side of town.
Well, we all gotta get busy. Only 24 hours to Miss Hairspray, and it's gonna be on national TV. We may never get another chance like this. First, I'm gonna start by getting Courtney and the guards at the studio to help us.
Maybe your dad could help too. He sometimes has ideas.
I know a guy that
can. No! I've got to turn myself in and go back to jail.
Say what?
Tracy, no!
I can't put all of you in any more danger. We should have thought more before we broke out. My dad could lose the Hardy Harpout. And think? You could go to prison for what you did tonight.
Oh, I just first base in the back of the cab, I swear!
Woohoo! Miss Motormouth, we've just been on three channels of news. I don't want you to get arrested for harboring a fugitive. And Penny, your mother will kill you. No, she'll kill him.
Hey, listen. I've only been to jail one time for backing up the white girl. Don't mind sitting this round out.
Yeah, I hear you. Besides, we already tried it and it didn't work.
And this time it won't be like Mother-Daughter Day again. Mrs. Von Tussle said there'll be armed guards at the Eventorium. With arms! Someone could get shot.
And for what? Just so we can dance on some old facial?
Yeah.
Hold it! Nobody ever said this was gonna be easy. If something's worth having, it's worth fighting for. Tracy, why'd you start all this in the first place? Was it just so you could dance on TV?
No.
Was it so you could get the boy?
No. I almost lost him because of it.
Then maybe it was just to get yourself famous.
No. I just think it's stupid that we can't all dance together.
So you tried once and failed. We can't get lazy when things get crazy. Children, you are not the first to try, and you will not be the last. But I'm here to tell you that I'm gonna keep lining up until someday somebody breaks through. And I've been looking at that door a lot longer than you.
What door?
The front door. There's a light in the darkness, though the night is black as my skin. There's a light burning bright, showing me the way. But I know where I've been. There's a cry in the distance. It's a voice that comes from deep within. There's a cry asking why I pray the answers of oh.
dress. You use hairspray and tell your mother her head she should smother with ultra glass.
me?
Well, of course you, Lander! But I also want a graduate degree in musicology with a minor in ethnic studies. Yeah. And there's something else I'd like to say. The Corny Collins Show is now on forever officially integrated!
Yeah. Oh, America, look up! Here is history right before your eyes. Television will never be the same.
This is marvelous. The phones are going crazy. The whole country's watching. Even the governor called. He's enjoying the show so much that he's granted a pardon to Tracy, plus a full scholarship to Essex Community College! You terrify this kind of publicity! Thelma, you are a genius!
I am? Yes, I am!
Ultra Clutch is about to launch an entirely new line of beauty products, and I want this woman to head the campaign!
I just don't know what to say.
Comes with its own offices, a company car, and a multi-figured salary.
I just don't know what to say.
Thelma Von Tussel, you are the newly appointed vice president of Ultra Glow, beauty products for women of color.
I just don't know what to say.
And America would like to hear you kids sing our new theme song. I think I can get you a recording contract.
Oh, my big friend.
But they told me that this would be the quickest way. You have got to be kidding me. Okay, everybody on your feet, please. That's it, Huffy Pup. Thank you very much. That's very kind. Oh, dear. This is what happens when you sit in the cheap seats. Oh. Where is she? I know you've got her. I saw it on TV. Penny? I hardly recognize you. Get up like that.
I'm a pretty girl, Mama.
And you look so happy. Oh, I can't say it's what I want. But this fine-looking cat-like black boy is responsible for the light in your eye. Then how could I object, sweetheart?
Mama! No. Oh.
This may not be the right moment since we're on national TV and all, but, oh, Tracy, if I don't kiss you now, oh, it just may bust a gut.
Oh, well, we wouldn't want you to hurt yourself now, would we?
That's my girl!
Before I get completely sick, will somebody tell me this? If she came in through the front door, what the hell is inside that can?
My masterpiece!
In the can since lunchtime. I wouldn't go right in there after me if I were you, honey. You know what I'm saying?